So someone is asking, what are the details of the informant that we have to take? Sir, if you take that question. What are the details of the informant we have to take?
Who are the informant? First, most commonly, hello.
Yes, sir.
So who are the informant? Informant mainly are mothers. Those who are accompanying the child, they are the informants. But in absence of mother, any family member like father or grandmother or grandfather, they may be informant. But mother will give you, able to give you the whole history and relevant points regarding the history. Okay, clear?
Sir, in the slide, it is given that given a point that is informant. What do we have to write in that, the relation with the child?
No, actually, what happened below 4 years of age, child could not explain the history properly. So they need an informant. Informant means accompanying the child. Most probably and most commonly, it is the mother. Okay. Then, in absence of mother, in some cases, there may be other family member, maybe father or grandmother, grandfather, etc. Okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then next.
Another question on the nutritional history.
Another question on nutritional history. They want that explanation.
Where the question?
Where the question?
Okay. Actually, if you go through the slides of nutritional history, then last of the nutritional history, we provide a summarized summary of nutritional history. Just go through it. Most of the cases, because protein energy malnutrition, you have to explain the whole of the nutritional history. Other than that case, you have just write down that summary also. Have you got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
বাকি অনেক জায়গায় প্রবলেম হচ্ছে
So developmental quotient can be done up to what age?
Developmental quotient can be done throughout the pediatric.
Hello, developmental proportion it needed throughout the pediatric period, but most commonly in little childs. You have to know. Actually, there is a problem. Yeah, we know that there is a problem in developmental history slides. Four slides, most probably four slides are given there, and somehow the explanation could not.
So the audio was not there.
I know that because when we explaining the developmental quotient, we come back to the first slide again from the last slide. Most probably for that reason, the explanation has been removed automatically. So first of all, I explain you what is needed. In developmental part, actually we assess the neurological. Actually, neurological assessment, is there any kind of neurological disorder or not? or in near future. And it has been assessed in four spheres of development: gross motor, fine motor, socio-personal, and language. After that assessment, we can say that if there is what is the probable age of the development? Maybe after assessment, the actual age may be 12 months. But after assessment, we get that the age of the development in developmental age is 3 months, because of the achievement of the milestone shows that the boy is 3 months old. So the developmental quotient may be 3/12, that is 25%. Okay. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Any other?
Hello, sir. Hello.
Any other question?
স্যার ওই যে ডেভেলপমেন্টাল যেটা স্কিলটা ছিল ওই ফাইন মোটর স্কিল আর ওইগুলো ওইখানে স্যার টেবিলে সামথিং আর লিখেছিল সামথিং ইন রেড আর সামথিং ইন ব্ল্যাক স্যার ওইটা তো স্যার আওয়াজটা তো শুনতে পাইনি স্যার ওই ডিফারেন্সটা কি হচ্ছিল স্যার ওইটা
রেড গুলো মানে হচ্ছে গিয়ে তোমার মেইন যে ইম্পর্টেন্ট গুলো আমরা দিয়েছি কিন্তু তোমাকে 5 বছর দিয়ে অ্যাকচুয়ালি ওটা 50 মান্থস দেওয়া আছে দ্যাট ওয়াজ নট 50 মান্থ দ্যাট উইল বি 60 মান্থ দ্যাট ইজ 5 ইয়ার্স তো তোমাকে যেটা করতে হবে যে ওই রেড মার্কস গুলো হচ্ছে কি মেইন ইম্পর্টেন্ট আমরা বলেছি যে গ্রসলি আমরা যখন ওয়ার্ডে এক্সামিন করব এইগুলোর উপর বেস করে এটা থিওরি নয় কিন্তু থিওরিতে তোমাকে ইন ডিটেলস সবগুলোই জানতে হবে কিন্তু গ্রসলি ওইগুলো যেমন ধরো গ্রসলি আমরা মোটরটাই দেখি মোটরটার মধ্যে সে দ্য বয় অ্যাচিভ দ্য নেক হোল্ডিং অ্যাট দি এজ অফ ইন গ্রস মোটর স্ফিয়ার লুক অ্যাট দ্যাট টেবিল that the child achieved neck holding at the age of 3 months. Thereafter, seat with support 5 to 6 months and without support, that is 9 months. And stand with support, that is 12 months, likewise. Okay. Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. And from that point, we assess the developmental quotient. Expected developmental quotient is 100%. If it is below that, then we call that the boy or girl, the child is suffering from developmental delay. If the four sphere, that is gross motor, fine motor, socio-personal, and language, all the four spheres are involved, then we tell that the child is suffering from global developmental delay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Actually, the developmental history is important when you are dealing with a case of neurology, right?
Yes, sir.
So, in pediatric examination, particularly in undergraduate examination, usually no neurological cases are given. So, you should write down the developmental history, either the developmental history is normal at per age or there is a developmental delay. When any examiner asks you what is the sector of development, then you have to answer all the four spectrum, that is the gross motor, fine motor, social language, social and language development, right? So usually in normal pediatric examination, these are not so important. Just you remember the few points, the when the social smile is achieved, when the neck holding is achieved, when the pincers is achieved, when there is a crawling, when there is a standing with support and stand and walking and like that. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Next, any question?
Sir, we should be calculate IQ in
development. No.
It actually not required to detail calculate the IQ in undergraduate. It is usually required in postgraduate history taking, because the neurological cases are usually not given in undergraduate examination.
Maybe given.
Okay.
put the question.
Sir, in nutritional history, do we have to calculate the calorie and the protein gram?
Actually, in nutritional history, we have given the summary of sample, how to write down the nutritional history, right? You have to mention the duration of the exclusive breastfeeding, when the weaning is started. That means weaning is not used nowadays. It is called the complementary feedings. And what the complementary feeding is given to the baby. And then when it is usually started with the liquid, then is the semi-solid, then is the solid foods, right? Then is the normal mixed diet. And you have to calculate the daily intake of calorie and the protein. And this is very important in case of protein energy malnutrition. You have to calculate what the baby has, the child has taken from day starting up to the day end. That is 24 hours intake of total calorie and the protein intake. If your case is not a protein energy malnutrition, you just simply write down that the baby, that the patient is on mixed Bengali diet and the average calorie intake, say 10 kg weight, so the average calorie intake is 700 to 800 kilocalorie per kg per kilocalorie per day, and the protein intake is 1 to 2 gram per kg per day, and that will suffice. Right. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, at antenatal care, আমাদের কি হিস্ট্রিটা নিতে হবে? তো তখন আমরা কি খালি নেগেটিভ হিস্ট্রি গুলো লিখবো এটাতে না সব পজিটিভ ফাইন্ডিং গুলো লিখতে হবে?
Negative, actually in antenatal history, whenever you write down the mother is a book case, that means she had undergone 3 antenatal checkup. One checkup in first trimester, another second checkup in second trimester, and third checkup is in third trimester, right? And during the antenatal checkup, thorough history and examinations were done. So when you write down the mother is booked case, that means they have, that means she has asked whether there is any having major problem. Say the mother developed the glucose intolerance during the pregnancy, that is called the gestational diabetes mellitus. You have to take it. But if the mother is suffering from diabetes before conception, you have to take it. Similarly, the hypertension, similarly the thyroid, these are the issues because this disease adversely affect the fetus outcome. Next, any history of fever, rash during the first trimester, that is torch infection, particularly the cytomegalovirus, rubella, they have got the adverse fetal outcome, right? So if your case is booked, that indicates you have asked all these things, so you need not require to inquire all these things. Just write down that it is a booked case. This also indicates that the mother has received iron and folic acid supplementation and 2 doses of tetanus toxoid 4 weeks apart.
Yes, sir. Right? Thank you, sir.
Yes, Shubham, you have write down that in immunization history, we should ideally check the immunization card. If it's not available and mother is not aware of all the vaccination, then what should we write in the section? Should we trust on the mother? Yes, if the card is not, antenatal card is not available, then you have to trust on the mother. That whether the baby has received primary 3 doses of vaccination at the 6 week of age, 10 weeks of age and 14 weeks of age. And you should look for the BCG card on the left hand upper side. So if you see the scar on the left side, that means the baby has received the BCG vaccination. And ask the mother whether it is a institutional or non-institutional delivery. In institutional delivery, usually all the babies receive the first dose of polio, that is called the 0 dose polio, and the hepatitis B and BCG vaccination. And if mother is unable to produce any immunization card, then you ask the mother whether she had visited the immunization clinic mentioning the 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks. If the mother can remember and tell yes, she had visited the immunization clinic, then you rely on the mother that baby is immunized.
Another thing, when you write down that part, then you should explain that the baby is immunized, but immunization card is not available at present. That will be justified, more justified. Okay?
Sir, in case of family history, should we draw the pedigree chart?
Yes, in family history, you should draw the pedigree chart of 3 generations. This will give you the clear idea regarding the family members, the father, mother, and the consanguinity, and the offspring, and the death or any disease in the siblings. And it will take minimum time. If you write down all these things, it will take more time, lot of time, right? So you should draw the pedigree chart, and you should practice it how to draw the pedigree chart. We have given a picture of pedigree chart, how to draw it, and I think there are some signs we have used, and you should remember that. Okay. What are the probable long cases that we might get in the exam? This is a very difficult question, but usually the common cases including the respiratory system, cardiovascular system, GI system, and the renal system and hematological system, these are the long cases that are usually given in the examination.
One of the most common cases already given as a prototype case, that is nephrotic syndrome. Other cases may be acute glomerulonephritis, then thalassemia. Thalassemia is one of the most common case. After this history or history taking class, the clinical examination class also started very soon. Then you will find that type of cases also.
Sure, Aritra. Is it clear to you? So we have already completed the first session. Now it is 1:30 p.m. So we should proceed for the next session. Mother will not able to tell properly the antenatal, intra or postnatal history, shall we write information can't be elicited? No, this should not be written. You have to ask, whatever be the educational level of the mother, she can remember the event of her pregnancy. If any adverse event occur during her pregnancy, she can remember, right? You have to give the first, you have to ask the open-ended question. You can ask the mother what happened during the first trimester of pregnancy. If the mother can't able to answer you properly, then you have to give some close-ended question. Did you have any problem in gestational diabetes mellitus, there is any problem in glucose metabolism or not? Mother can't remember the glucose metabolism, but she can remember whether there is any problem with pressure, high pressure, pregnancy induced hypertension or not, etc. You have to give some leading questions so that mother can answer either yes or no, right? But you should never write that information can't be elicited. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Next, we expect more questions from you. Sir, can we please quickly summarize the points in history taking once? Summary. Actually, there is no summary in case of history taking. There is a case summary. There may be case summary after taking the whole history and the clinical examination. But when we progress to the next part of the examination, that is next part, then we summarize mentally that what are the positive points and exclude the negative points, go through these problems vividly and try to find out which organ or which system is involved, try to find out the etiology, that is it infectious or malignancy or autoimmune, and then try to find out what kind of complications and severity of the disease is lying down. Okay. Put your question quickly. Time is running out. Okay, another question, sir. Is your question, Bala, sir?
Srijan, antenatal history always necessarily taken.
Antenatal history always necessarily taken?
Yes, antenatal history should always be taken because in pediatric age group, the antenatal event can adversely affect the outcome of the fetus. So, those who are having some deformities, and it may be due to the internal infection, particularly say in torch infection, you have to take the antenatal history. The child did not cry at birth, and if you inquire that mother whether the baby or whether the mother can feel the movement of the baby in utero, if the mother said my child not moving adequately during antenatal period, particularly second and third trimester, that indicate there is a less fetal movement, and this less fetal movement along with there is a no cry or difficult resuscitation and indicate that baby is suffering from some disease which can help you diagnose, that is the spinal muscular atrophy, right? So this antenatal, internatal and postnatal history is very important. Another example, say you are dealing with a case of a cerebral palsy child, and if you inquire whether the baby cried immediately after birth or not, whether the resuscitation measures were applied or not, if mother says that baby did not cry at birth and baby required resuscitation and Apgar score was poor, that indicate the baby suffered from hypoxemic ischemic encephalopathy, and that is the cause of cerebral palsy. So these are very important for assessment, particularly the developmental history assessment and the other examinations. When required, you need to inquire about the antenatal, internatal and postnatal histories. Nutritional history.
Okay. Mohit, you have asked that what to do with nutritional history. Okay. Actually, it is difficult for you. It has some difficulties to find out how much calorie and protein the baby has taken. We have provided a chart, a very summarized way that how much calorie or protein is found in common foods. From there, you can simply find out the calorie is taken, calorie or protein taken by the baby. Then there is also some points given that how much calorie and protein they needed at that particular age. from there you can find out the calorie or protein gap. From there you can take a idea that the baby is the baby suffering from protein allergy, malnutrition or not. Again, we are telling that these kind of cases are not available at this time, that protein allergy, malnutrition. But some cases where secondary malnutrition, that is the boy, if the baby is suffering from cardiovascular disease, that is congenital heart disease like ventricular septal defect or any other chronic disease which causes the malnutrition, that is secondary malnutrition, then you can tell that, you can write down that the baby has taken all that calorie and protein appropriate for that age group, and the malnutrition is due to the secondary cause, may be the secondary cause. Then second question.
Rikhi Bhattacharya, you have asked that socioeconomic status, is there any special significance in putting down the exact Kukushami classification? In socioeconomic status, the socioeconomic status is classified on the scale of Kukushami index. So you need not required to classify, just you write down it is a poor socioeconomic condition or it is a higher socioeconomic condition. You need not required to write down the Kukushami index, right?
Okay, another question.
Stop feeding. What is stop feeding after?
Oh. Shatnik asked, what is stop feeding? Stop feeding means any feeding that is given, that is extra, that is exclusive breastfeeding, means from birth up to 6 months, nothing is given to the baby except the medication. Anything that is given in the form of either artificial formula or the animal milk. Animal milk means cow milk, buffalo milk, camel milk, goat milk, whatever it may be. If it is given, that is called the top feeding, right?
Another question by Mohit, that is necessary to mention calorie or protein intake value. If you can give a gross idea, then it will be better. But if you are not able to do this, then you will just tell that the baby is appropriately given appropriately calorie and total protein. That will be enough for you. In development, Srijan, development history, do we attempt to elicit all the points in the screening schedule or do simply ask the mother? No, actually, you can write if the development is normal. So, a patient of thalassemia came to you and you have to explain the developmental history. You can write down that the baby is achieved neck holding at the age of 3 months. Seat without support at the age of 8 to 9 months and can run at the age of 18 months. That will suffice to explain that the baby is the development of the baby is appropriate for his age.
Next, Rikia, you have asked how to elicit the Apgar score by history. So if the mother can remember her baby's postnatal history was uneventful, that means the baby did not require any resuscitative method, that indicate the Apgar score in 0-1 and 5 minutes was normal, that is 10-10-10. So if the mother can tell that no resuscitative measures were taken in the immediate postnatal life, that indicate the baby cried immediately after birth, right? So in that case, you will write that there is postnatal no history was uneventful and the baby cried immediately after birth, nothing else. And Shomo has written, immunization card is not available, what to ask next? So this question was put in the previous section. Now, if the mother unable to produce the immunization card, then you ask the mother whether it is a institutional delivery or home delivery. If institutional delivery, usually the BCG vaccination and the first dose oral polio and the hepatitis B vaccination given. So then you ask the mother whether the baby received the immunization at 6 week, 10 week and 14 week. If the mother can remember, yes, I have visited the immunization clinic at 6, 10 and 14 weeks, that indicate the baby received the pentavalent vaccinations, right? So when the mother or the caregiver unable to produce the immunization card, you just trust on the mother or the caregiver, and if the history is good, then you can trust that the baby is immunized as per immunization schedule. And for the BCG vaccination, you can check the BCG scar on the left side of the upper arm. So the left upper arm, you can see the BCG scar. If the scar is available, then it is sure that the BCG vaccination was given. So if the immunization card is not available, then you can trust the mother or the caregiver.
Sir?
Yeah. Yes.
Sir, in immunization schedule, we have so many vaccines, and if immunization card is not available, if mother says yes, she has visited, then how could we know that what vaccines she has taken in that week? Means we have read in PSM, if immunization card is not available, we have to consider that the child is not immunized and we have to again start immunization means accordingly.
No, you just write down that the baby is immunized as per national immunization schedule according to the mother or caregiver, but the immunization card is not available.
You have to mention it.
You have to mention it.
Okay, sir.
And Surya, you have asked that should we use 24 hours recall method for nutrition? Yes, when your case is related to the malnutrition, you should use this 24 hours recall method for the exact calculation of the protein and calorie intake. If your case is not related to the protein energy malnutrition, say you are dealing with a case of VSD or say thalassemia or say nephrotic syndrome, you just write down that the protein and the calorie intake of the baby. Usually we have given a format that the protein intake is 1 to 2 gram per kg per day and the calorie intake is 70 to 80 kilocalorie per kg per day. Say the child is 10 kg body weight, so your calorie intake will be 800 kilocalorie per day and the protein intake will be say 15 to 20 gram per day. So it is clear, Surya?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, next question. So, Srijan. So do you draw out a broad hypothesis? Actually, this is for my understanding. Yeah. Your history is stopped in social history, but it's okay. Then you have to progress. You have to draw a broad hypothesis in your mind that which system is involved or which organ is involved, and you have to you have asked that what will be the probable diagnosis, not provisional, what will be the probable diagnosis from your history. Then you go through the clinical examination, that is first part is general survey, that will come in later classes. This is not needed to write down in your history taking. Next question, sir, please explain how to do development history part in detail. Actually, you have not need to need a detailed developmental history. A boy, say a 3 years old boy came to you for thalassemia, and the boy can run and talk with some three to six word sentences and can play with his peer groups, then you can tell that the boy is, the developmental of the boy is appropriate for his age.
Next, Shomo, you have asked, sir, what do we need to ask in case of delivery at home? Yes, this is That means the non-institutional delivery. In non-institutional delivery, you have to rely on the mother or the caregiver or the family member. If the mother is unable to remember the episodes, whether the baby cried immediately after birth or not, and whether the baby suffered from any complication immediately after birth that needs medical help. If the answer is yes, that indicates there is a eventful history. And if the history is no, that is the uneventful. In that case, you will say it is a non-institutional or home delivery, and the baby immediately cried after birth, and no resuscitative measures were taken.
Next question, Ritan. Do we have to do problem-oriented tests? No, you need not to do that. Flow sheet analysis, no summary is needed, but keep the probable diagnosis in your mind and go through the next part, that is clinical examination. Sijan, sir, do we need to keep in mind the caloric value, caloric values of some common foods like boiled rice, chapati? It is given in your charts also. And to understand, it is given in very fluid and accessible way. Do we need to calculate intake? Gross calculation is needed. If again we are telling you that if there is no kind of malnutrition or primary malnutrition, that is protein energy malnutrition, so you need not to inquire such questions also. Just write down that the baby is there is no calorie or protein gap of the baby, and the nutrition is at per age.
Sir, in development history, we know that it is a very huge chart. And suppose if any child comes at the age of 40, so some development has achieved and some is yet to achieve. So basically, if I know my case is thalassemia or nephrotic syndrome, there is no any neurological problem. Then yeah. Just we will ask if baby is able to walk, smile, then we will ask, yes, development is adequate according to age.
Yes, in developmental history, if your case is not a neurological case, that is developmental delay or like that, you need not require to inquire all the sectors in detail. You just write down that the developmental history is normal at per age. Say you should ask when the baby achieved social smile, neck holding, then the Prinzer's grasp, then is the crawling, then standing with support, standing without support, and walking. Nothing else, because your case is not related to the neurology. Your case is related to the, say, thalassemia or nephrotic syndrome or any other case. In that case, the developmental history is not so significant. Just you have to mention as a part that you have taken the developmental history, and just you mention that the developmental history is normal at per age. Okay.
So, Srijan, next question you have asked. Thank you. That. Particular method to approach a child since wards are now okay. Actually, there is no particular. If you are empathetic enough that a mother is come to you with very anxiety that the baby is suffering from febrile seizure, the whole family is in a very anxious mood, then you just calm down the patient. And you have to not only talk, but you have to do something, put the oxygen. These procedures, yes, it is very necessary to do the ward work, to put the patient in a oxygen and try to access the IV lines and talk with them with very empathetic way. That is the way you can establish the bilateral communication with the patient party.
Next, Sakshi, you have asked, sir, with age, BP of children varies, right? Do we need to remember all the upper limits and lower limits of blood pressure values of each age group?
Most probably blood pressure.
Yes. So you need not require to remember the upper and the lower age group, lower limit of blood pressure in each age group. In that case, you can bring the BP chart. You will be allowed to bring the BP chart according to the age group So in that case, you can write down whether the baby is hypertensive or normotensive. Okay, you need not require to remember all the values.
Homeopathy does not work. Srijan, okay, you have put lots of questions and okay, look, actually when we came to the examination also, you have to build up your rapport. In some OPDs or private chambers also, some doctors do that, but to take the baby in confidence. Okay. Now what will be the proper method, that is not important. It is very important to take your take the baby in your confidence. Okay, Srijan, please put your answer response. We
so we have completed
one more with current
তখন মোস্ট অফ দ্য টাইম আসে ওরা ব্লাড ট্রান্সফিউশনের জন্য রুটিন ব্লাড
ট্রান্সফিউশন
তখন আমরা চিফ কমপ্লেইন্টটা কি লিখব
Yes, exactly. You never write down the chief complaint patient is admitted for blood transfusion. This is the first and foremost thing you should remember. Right?
Yes, sir.
So what you should write down, say the patient is 6, 7, 10, whatever, say 6 years old boy or girl has presented before you for blood transfusion and he is a known case of thalassemia. And whenever you ask the mother or the caregiver why you have admitted here, she will simply answer for blood taking blood transfusion, right?
Yes, sir.
So your chief complaint should never be patient is admitted for blood transfusion. You inquire or ask the mother what problem the patient developed. The mother can say my child is having weakness, lethargy, fever, cough and cold or whatever it may be, right? Now, for say 5 or 10 days or 15 days or 1 month, whatever it may be. So this will be the chief complaint, and during the present illness part, whenever you are elaborating the history, then you will go back when the disease started first. Say it is detected at the age of 1 year. So your history will start from the age of 1 year, patient developed such and such problem for which the patient admitted in the hospital and diagnosed as a case of thalassemia and received blood transfusion. And now the patient is admitted for here for weakness, lethargy, fever, cough and cold or whatever it may be. And patient is receiving regular blood transfusion at an interval of say 6 months, 2 months, 1 month, whatever it may be, right?
Sir, means, blood transfusion nite hobe. So before the precipitation of symptoms ora chole ashe. এবং যদি আমাকে সেটাই বলে যে আমার 6 মাস হয়ে গেছে আমি তার জন্য চলে এসেছি
during after 6 months patient definitely have developed some problem. Either the mother will say my child is not taking food adequately, my child is becoming pale, my child is lethargic, my child has developed poor scholastic performance, my child is having fever, cough, diarrhea, whatever it may be, right? There must be some issues, but blood transfusion is not the chief complaint.
আমি আরেকবার বলে দিচ্ছি তোমাদেরকে যে যেটা বলছিলে তুমি যে 6 মাস পরেও তো জানেই নিতে আসবে ব্লাড, তাহলে আর কি দরকার আছে? না, তোমারটা যখন কেসটা আসবে না, ওই কেসটা নয়, তোমার কাছে একটা নতুন থ্যালাসেমিয়া কেসই আসবে, তুমি ধরে নেবে, তখন তুমি নতুন করে দেখবে, সে তখন হয়তো নাও জানতে পারে, সেই জন্য শুরুটা এটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি দিস ইজ এ কাইন্ড অফ রেট্রোস্পেক্টিভ হিস্ট্রি, দিস ইজ নট পাস্ট হিস্ট্রি। এইটাই আমরা দেওয়ার জন্য উই হ্যাভ গিভেন অ্যা স্যাম্পল অফ নেফ্রোটিক সিনড্রোম, যে কেন হিস্ট্রিটা হচ্ছে কি এই পয়েন্টে এসছে সে ব্লাড নেওয়ার জন্য, কিন্তু ওটা স্টার্ট হয়েছে টু ইয়ার্স ব্যাক, থ্রি টু ফোর অর ফাইভ টু সিক্স এপিসোডস অলরেডি গন, সুতরাং ওইখান থেকেই শুরু করতে হবে। আর তার সঙ্গে একটা পয়েন্ট বললেন, দ্য প্রেজেন্ট এপিসোড স্টার্টেড ফ্রম অমুক ডে, যে থ্রি টু ফাইভ ফোর ডেজ ব্যাক ই সাফারিং ফ্রম দ্যাট কাইন্ড অফ উইকনেস অর জেনারেল বডি এ কে
মানে স্যার থ্যালাসেমিয়ার কেসটাতে আমি শুধু প্রেজেন্ট হিস মানে প্রেজেন্ট এপিসোডটা না, অল থ্রু আউট দ্য প্রেজেন্ট মানে এপিসোডস আমি একটা জেনারেলাইজড হিস্ট্রি নিচ্ছি।
এক্স্যাক্টলি, দ্যাট ইজ রেট্রোস্পেকটিভ হিস্ট্রি, দ্যাট ইজ নট পাস্ট হিস্ট্রি। এটা এটা ডিফারেন্সিয়েট করার জন্যই থ্যালাসেমিয়া কেসটা খুব ইম্পর্টেন্ট। নেফ্রোটিক সিন্ড্রোমও তাই, যে ওটা ছ মাস থেকে শুরু হয়ে এখন ও চার পাঁচবার এই ছবার বা আটবার ব্লাড নিয়েছে, এইটা পুরোটা এক্সপ্লেন করতে হবে। সো তার সঙ্গে একটা আচ্ছা আর একটা কোয়েশ্চেন প্রীতম একটা কোয়েশ্চেন করেছে, প্রীতম হ্যাভ আস্কড দ্যাট দ্য what kind of long case and short case cases most probably nephrotic syndrome, acute glomerulonephritis, thalassemia, ventricular septal defect, congenital heart disease in case of congenital heart disease, or
respiratory system
acute hepatitis, and in the respiratory system that is pleural effusion, pneumonia, pleural effusion, that kind of question cases are
getting nephrotic. So we'll complete our this session. Ronak has asked, nephrotic syndrome, do we need to mention the specific cause of professional diagnosis like minimal change? No, you need not required to mention the pathological diagnosis. You just mention this is a case of nephrotic syndrome because your diagnosis is probable and that will be confirmed after lab investigation. So you should write down this is a case of nephrotic syndrome. Whenever examiner will ask you what may be your cause case, then you can answer it might be minimal change disease, but actually it will be confirmed after investigation, say a histopathological examination.
Second
part. Sir, ekta question ache ki thalassemia patient eseche amra treatment korechi, kintu means when we will ask patient to come next, when after a particular fixed date or when the symptom will occur?
Actually, you have to so when the symptom occurs. Actually, the in thalassemia cases, there is a follow-up. There is also follow-up. Follow-up for what? Follow-up for this part actually needed in case of postgraduate. Follow-up of growth monitoring, follow-up of endocrinal abnormalities, follow-up of is there any cardiac abnormality or not. But in undergraduate cases, we just tell them that you please come 2 to 3 weeks after. And some cases, we tell them that please draw a blood sample for hemoglobin. That's all.
Thank you, sir.
We can use our face masks and we have to may put the grade 2, level 2 or level 3 that PP kind of PP and to maintain a safe distance such as 2 meter safe distance and talk to the parents and patients also. And in case of mother, we are doing these kinds of things regularly in our ward also. How can we say the patient is suffering from nephrotic syndrome without measuring protein level in people?
So, Sakshi, your question is, sir, how can we say the patient is suffering from nephrotic syndrome without measuring protein level in urine? Yes, first you have to ascertain the edema, right? When you are getting a patient of edema, you have to do the differential diagnosis. What are the causes of generalized edema? One is renal cause, nephrotic syndrome. Another is cardiovascular cause, congestive cardiac failure. Another is liver cause, chronic liver disease. And another is protein energy malnutrition. Right. So you have to inquire all this system and you have to take the history appropriately. And say your case is nephrotic syndrome. So you have to inquire about the patients regarding the protein energy malnutrition, the intake of protein and the calorie and the skin changes, whether present or not. The patient, whether the patient has suffered from jaundice in recent or the remote past. So you have to inquire about that, whether the baby has undergone exchange transfusion in the neonatal period. You have to ask for that. And whether the baby has suffered from any kind of hepatitis in the recent or remote past. And cardiovascular diseases, you have to ask for the syncopal attack, then is the breathlessness, then is the urine output, cough, etc., like that. So with asking all these questions, you have to you have come to conclusion that all the three systems, that is protein energy malnutrition, the cardiovascular system and the liver disease, has been excluded. Then your diagnosis is that it edema might be due to the renal cause,
probable
diagnosis, right? Then you have to do the serum albumin level estimation.
That is next part, investigational part, only history taking.
Oh, only history taking. So this is up to the history. Okay. So this negative history involving the other system can cause the generalized edema. You have to exclude so that you can point your diagnosis towards the renal cause.
Okay. One thing, if you go through our slides and PPT presentations, then you can find the history of patient illness. History of patient illness in case of nephrotic syndrome, it is different. And what sir have said, that the differential diagnosis are excluded by the means of negative history. That is part B. Actually, that is the part B of the history of patient illness. Okay. And that will come like a cardiovascular system disease or protein energy malnutrition, etc. Okay,
Titas, you have asked in case of blood transfusion history, how to differentiate among whole blood transfusion, platelet transfusion, packed RBC transfusion, caregiver may confuse. Yes. So you ask the mother or the caregiver what kind of blood has been given, whether it is red blood or white blood. Red blood indicate that is either whole blood transfusion or packed RBC transfusion. White blood may be platelet transfusion or plasma transfusion. So your case is, say, thalassemia. So the baby, so the child or the patient will receive either the whole blood or the packed RBC. And the mother or the caregiver can easily answer that my child has received red blood or the white blood, right?
Next question. Sir, what are the significant points that we need to look out for in internatal period in history taking,
yes,
of the mother?
Valentine, you have asked what are the significant points that we need to look out for in intranatal period in the history taking of the mother. Yes, intranatal period means you ask the mother whether it is institutional delivery or non-institutional delivery. If it is institutional delivery, then you ask the mother whether it is normal vaginal delivery or the cesarean section. If the cesarean section, then you ask the mother what is the indication for cesarean section, right? In case of normal vaginal delivery, you ask the gravida and para of the mother. In case of first gravida or the first para, you may encounter some intranatal problem, but in subsequent cases, you may not get any problem. So these are the things that you have to ask in the intranatal period. And in postnatal period, you have to ask the mother the status of the baby. If the mother can remember whether the baby has cried immediately after birth or not, whether any resuscitative measure required or not, and when the baby started breastfeeding. Normal delivery, the breastfeeding usually started within half an hour, though the upper limit is 1 hour, and in cesarean section within 1 hour, though the upper limit is 4 hours. So you can ask all these questions.
Next question. Please put your question.
Sir, developmental milestones. The history taking a developmental milestone. Tarpore hocche je amader sir antenatal history, postnatal history. এইগুলো আমাদের লং কেস গুলোতে তো মোর অর লেস নরমাল পাবো, নাকি আমাদের কয়েকটা লং কেসে এরকম কিছু স্পেসিফিক জিনিস এলিসিট করতে হয়?
না, অ্যাকচুয়ালি কি হয় যে তোমাদের শেষে দেখবে ওই স্লাইড গুলো শেষে একটা সামারি, ছোট্ট করে সামারি দেওয়া আছে যেটা তোমাদেরকে লিখতে হবে। যেমন ধরো যে আমরা আবারও বলছি একটা থ্যালাসেমিয়া কেস আসলো বা একটা নেফ্রোটিক সিন্ড্রোম কেস আসলো, যে সে 3 বছর বয়স, দেন ইউ হ্যাভ টু এলিসিট দ্য ডেভেলপমেন্টাল হিস্ট্রি লাইক ওয়াইজ দ্যাট দ্য বয় অর গার্ল অ্যাচিভ হিজ নেক হোল্ডিং অ্যাট দি এজ অফ 3 মান্থস, বয় অ্যান্ড অর গার্ল মে অ্যাচিভ না সিট উইদাউট সাপোর্ট অ্যাট দি এজ অফ 9 মান্থস, can stand without support at the age of 14 to 15 months. Likewise, you can tell that the explain that the developmental history is appropriate for age. Okay, that will cover all these things. Okay, and another question, antenatal, natal, they are also written a summary slide. They are also written a summary slide where it is written that the like that the mother is a booked case, that means she received all the tetanus toxoids, iron folic acid combinations and regular antenatal checkup, and the delivery was institutional, that is maybe is cesarean section or single vaginal delivery. Then the baby is cried soon after birth, so there is no perinatal insult to the baby, so the development, so the birth history is normal. That is enough for you.
Okay, sir.
Mehul has asked if the child has grown, mother is unable to recall antenatal, internatal, and postnatal history many times. Right? What to do in that case? Yes, in that case, this is a very interesting question. Mother is unable to remember the all these things, that is antenatal, internatal and postnatal history. Then you ask the mother whether the whether she has developed any complication during her pregnancy, starting from the beginning up to the end and in the postnatal life, in the baby. So mother can clearly remember any major medical event or surgical event during her pregnancy, so that you can get the antenatal history. And internatal history, you ask the mother whether there is a institutional or home delivery. In institutional delivery, you ask the mother whether it is a normal vaginal delivery or the cesarean section, and if cesarean section, the indication of cesarean section. Then you ask the mother, can you remember the body weight of the baby? If the mother say no, I can remember the weight of the baby, then you can ask the mother whether the baby was small or large. She can remember. If the mother say my baby was large enough, that indicate the antenatal period was normal and the baby developed normally. And in the postnatal life, you ask the mother whether there is any gross abnormality in the postnatal life. If mother said no, the postnatal history, the baby grown well, that indicate the postnatal history was uneventful. Right? Like this way, you can inquire about the antenatal, intranatal and postnatal history.
So, sir, what to make, Shipra, you have asked that, sir, what to do if mother targets forgets immunization card and can put, look, there are two to three points. You have to, you have to inquire first that the mother is visited the health center regularly or not. She can tell you that, and you have to find out, is there any BCG scar to the child that in deltoid region of the left arm. Then you can put your immunization history such that the baby is immunized appropriate for his age as per national immunization schedule, but mother cannot provide the immunization card. That will be enough for you.
So any questions from anybody? So we are having only 8 minutes left. Yes, Mrinalini, you have asked, do we examine the developmental milestone for age in the baby, or do we ask the mother whether the milestones were achieved on time? Yes, this is a very interesting question. If the mother can remember the developmental history, like the social smile, neck holding, next is the crawling, cooing, then is the pincers grasp, sitting with support, sitting without support, standing with support, standing without support, then it's okay. If mother is unable to remember and the answer is confusing, then you ask the mother, do you think your child is lagging behind from any other siblings in your family? If the question is no, that my child is growing at par with the other siblings in the family, that indicates the developmental milestone is normal. And if say no, my child is lagging in development from the other siblings in the family, that means he or she has got some developmental delay. And in that case, you have to inquire all the 4 sectors of development very carefully. Otherwise, you need not require to assess the development, each sector of the development individually. Clear? Next, any questions? Next, another question.
Actually, nutritional history. Look, if there is any kind of malnutrition, say the thalassemia boy came to you and the weight for the baby has at par age and there is no malnutrition, then you have to, you have not to inquire such nutritional history in VVD. But if there is any kind of malnutrition, then you have just asked what kind of food is offering to the baby in four or five phases of throughout the day, and put it in your total recall method and find out the calorie value. First calorie value, some food calorie value are given in your PPT slides, and the volume of the measuring instrument also given there. From there you can find out a gross idea, and from there you can calculate the given calorie and protein value to the baby. After that you can calculate the protein and calorie intake, what should be to the baby, that also given to the slide, that in children protein requirement maybe 1 to 2 gram per day, and calorie requirement up to one age, that is 1000 kilocalorie. After that, for every year, he or she need 100 kilocalorie per year. That if a 5 year boy come to you and the calorie intake should be like that, for first year it is 100, and for next year, next 4 years, that is 4 into 100, that is 1400 calorie, and the protein is protein should be the per kg weight. You should know the weight of the baby, then from that you can calculate that. Okay,
next, any question? So we are having only 3 minutes. Sipra Mondal has asked, in many cases mother directly tell us to the diagnosis, like the baby has leukemia or thalassemia. In that case, how to proceed? Yes, you never write down that the baby is suffering from leukemia or thalassemia. You ask the mother or the caregiver, what are the problem for which your baby is seeking medical advice. So say in that case thalassemia, it may be due to the lethargy, weakness, low grade fever, poor feeding, like that. Or in case of leukemia, low grade fever for long time, cough and cold, swelling of the neck glands, or lethargy, or the bleeding manifestation, say there is a bleeding spot on the limb or the body, like that. You have to inquire about that, right? When the mother say my child is suffering from leukemia, you did not write down that that the chief complaint is baby suffered from leukemia or thalassemia, like that.
Two questions are, Titas asked that the developmental delay is present but causing no symptoms. Actually, it is not possible. If the baby is suffering from developmental, say the 12 month boy came and he is not achieved that seat without support, then you can tell that the boy is suffering from developmental delay. It is simple. Yes, you have to put that in your history. Next question, do you have to write the negative history? Negative history is very important. It is for the exclusion of the differential diagnosis. So a case of soiling, sir has already explained that. I say case of soiling has come and the probable diagnosis may be the nephrotic syndrome. So what are the causes of soiling, generalized soiling? Then it might be a case of cardiovascular system, it might be due to the chronic liver disease. So from negative history, we have to exclude the history of chronic liver disease, history of proteinuria, malnutrition, history of congestive cardiac failure, like that. Negative history is very, very, very important.
Shoham, you have asked, sir, what are the common long cases we are given in the exams? That is, this question is asked from all the three groups. So, the thing is that the systems that are given in the examination, the first thing you will be happy to hear that no neurological cases given in undergraduate examination.
Probably,
right? Next is the mainly cases are given in the hematological system, say thalassemia and bleeding disorders. And in renal system, the acute glomerulonephritis, nephrotic syndrome. And in respiratory system, this is bronchiolitis, pneumonia, bronchial asthma. Pleural effusions. And in case of digestive system, it is given the jaundice, hepatitis and other causes of jaundice. That means hepatitis and jaundice, chronic liver disease. And cardiovascular system, mainly you are given congenital heart diseases, three congenital heart diseases, ASD, VSD and PDA, and tetralogy of Fallot's. Usually no other cases are given in the undergraduate examinations. So these are the common cases that are actually given in the long case. And you have to write down the history, a sample history, how to take the long case history that has been provided to you in PDF format. You just go through it, you will get an idea that how to write down the history portion. And next portion, that is the general survey and the systemic examination, that will be dealt in the next classes. So after that history, general survey, systemic examination, you will come to a conclusion of differential diagnosis, and then your history will be completed.
Another question is has come that is PM given as long case? Actually, you know that PM case is very difficult and it is not also given in postgraduate examination also. But sometimes it may be given, but not your undergraduate examination. It is very, very occasional. And before that, you have to prepare the cases already said by the sir. That cases is that those cases are more important. PM cases are very difficult, yes, we know that, but it also be discussed in later classes also. So follow that those classes, you will find that substance also in that classes.